If you need to determine the indent level, so for example, here we've got a whole bunch of account numbers, and the indentation actually means something. So the fact that all of those are indented the same means they're at the same level. So the first thing is just make sure it's a proper indent, so something created with these buttons, as opposed to spaces. And a quick way to see that is if it's got spaces, so for example, if I click on that one, is actually you can see there are spaces here versus over here, where in the formula bar it's right against the left, but here you can see it's indented. So as a result, it's actually, we've used these buttons here. To get the indent level, instead of you clicking on that and then seeing how many times you must push backwards to get it, you could just click on a cell and either right click and you'll see there's format cells, or we like to use the shortcut of Control 1. And you'll see under the alignment tab, there's an indent option, and it actually tells you what the number is. So this one is indented 6 times. If I say cancel and I went to that one, Control 1, you'll see it's indented 2x. So you can actually see what level it is on individual cells. And if you need to change them, you can. But what if you have to get the indent level of all these cells? Now, there is some VBA code that can do it, but we're also going to just show you a way, if you're not comfortable with VBA, how you can achieve something similar, where what we'll do is we're going to get Excel to tell us all the cells that are at the same level, and then we can go and set up perhaps a level number or something like that. So in normal Excel, the only tool that can find or see these indents is actually the Find Replace tool. So we're just going to show you how to use that. And let's just go through the steps. So I'm going to go Control F. Now the important thing here is we're not finding anything in here. We're actually going to find something in the format. So you'll see I'm going to click on this format option. And I'm going to look for something with 2 indents. And when I say OK, now before, if I click this now, it's going to search everywhere. However, normally with these things, I'm going to just highlight that column. So we've done nothing else here. I'm going to just say find all. And you'll see it's found 2 items. Now, if you can go to them individually, you'll see it's jumping around. But a nice trick to know is if you click on the first one, hold shift, and click on the last one, you can see it's highlighted those 2. And for now, what we're going to do is I'm just going to change the color. We'll just do that color there. And you'll see those 2 are now a light green. Now I'm going to continue to do the same thing, but something to watch out for, because we now have highlighted those 2, if I did another find, it would only search those 2. So before I do anything, I must just remember, highlight that column again. I'm going to format, and this time I'm going to look for, and I happen to know, so let's go to 6. I know they happen to be in even numbers. I'm going to say okay. When I say find all, you'll see it's found a lot more. I could do it individually, but rather click on the first one, go to the end, hold shift down and click, and you'll see it's now highlighted all of them that are at a level 6. I'm going to go maybe change it to that color. Again, remember, click somewhere else, highlight the column, and then you can continue. Now you'll see we've got all the levels at different colors. Before we do anything else though, just one thing. When you're using that find replace in that way, it does tend to remember what you did. So just to show you what the problem is, can you see I've got a 38 there? I'm just going to go Control Find. Now I just go here and I say 38. When I say find next, it says it can't find it. So what you must do, as soon as you've finished using the format part, Excel remembers this format. So when I click in here, when I typed 38 there, I was looking for 38, but it also had to have a level of 9. So what you need to do is just before you do anything else, just go here and just say clear find format. Will drive you nuts in other situations because Excel remembers it. Let's just go check and just make sure it's now finding. So you'll see now it's finding all the various 38s and it's not looking for that level. So just more, you'll work on another spreadsheet. You'll be trying to do a find, but it'll say it's not there even though you know it is there. So just remember that. Getting back to the indents. Now, not only do we have the indent, but we've actually got a color. And the benefit of the color is you can now, you've got two tools in Excel that notices color. You can either sort based on the colors, or we prefer to use the filter. So you'll see we've set up a filter here. And I can now go and filter by color. And for example, I'm going to use that blue there. And I know these were level 6. So I'm going to just type in a 6 for here and go control paste. And those are all level 6. And then let me go here. I can go to more cell colors and use that color there. I know those are level 9, so I'm going to put a 9. And so you can continue. And now you can see we've got levels next to all the indents. As mentioned, there's a little bit of VBA code that can actually extract this quickly. However, in certain cases, it might be a simple spreadsheet or it's just one or two cells, where this method may actually be a little bit more efficient.